Welcome to Tales from SYL Ranch, the BitChu channel where everyone is entitled to my opinion, and I'm Bill Stone. While I have your attention, I'd like to ask that if you like what I'm doing, please like this video, subscribe to my channel, hit the notification bell, share me on social media, and tell all of your friends, family, neighbors, pets, and livestock to do the same. I would appreciate your support via my PayPal tip jar, my Subscribestar, my merch stores on Teespring, or a place on my website where you can support me further. And there are links to all of these in my description box. Well, oh my God. The Ukrainian scandal isn't what you think. It's not even remotely what you think. In fact, you need to completely forget every damned thing you've ever heard about it. The phone call that President Trump had with the Ukrainian president isn't the beginning of the scandal. It's only the latest and, frankly, the most ethical action in a long chain of events. Now, I want to preface what I'm about to say. Usually, when I present something that I think is news, it's something that I have personally researched. While I offer opinions on many, many things, when I have something that I think is news, I try to be as fair as possible. And I do this by trying to be a fair witness. Now, this is a fictional profession seen in Robert A. Heinlein's classic novel, A Stranger in a Strange Land. Now, in the novel, a fair witness was an observer who made no assumptions about anything that they weren't currently seeing or otherwise experiencing with their own senses. So, for example, if you asked a fair witness the color of the house across the street, they would say, it's white on this side. They wouldn't assume anything about the other sides of the house. Even if they walked around the house and they saw that the rest of the sides were white, well, they wouldn't assume that it remained white the moment that they stopped looking at it. As far as they were concerned, any side could spontaneously turn green the moment they weren't looking at it. So that's what I try to do when I'm presenting straight up news on the show. I'm not always successful, but then I don't think anybody can be. Now, this is massively different than today's press. As always scrolls past on my lower third, nothing you see in the press is real. Nothing. And I say this because for 30 years, I have made a rather masochistic hobby of debunking the press. I can now do it with any story from any news source. It doesn't matter what it is. ABC, NBC, CBS, PBS, MSNBC, Fox News, the New York Times, and any local newspaper or TV outlet that you want to throw at me. Inside of 30 minutes, I can prove one of three things. Either that the event being reported never happened, that it didn't happen as reported, or that when stripped of opinion, emotionally loaded language, and unrelated filler, the facts devolve to a couple of paragraphs at best. And I've done this several times on my show, and frankly, if you want to see me do it again, it's about time. Here's what I suggest you do. Find me a story from a print source, because that's easier for me to debunk with, you know, showing it on the screen and stuff. Any print source that you want. Throw it at me. I will not look at it. I will not script an episode like I have here. I won't script anything. I will walk through the thing cold. I will not look at it in advance. I will just walk through it cold on the show and debunk it. Now, in point of fact, one of the things that becomes most obvious when you debunk the press is that all of them, with no exceptions, have a massively leftist bias. The press, now, they honestly believe that they have no bias, but this is because they're surrounded by nothing but leftists. If all you're ever surrounded by is people who have the same views as you, then you get the mistaken impression that it's the way everyone thinks. Since before President Trump was elected, the press has been on a jihad to destroy him. Anything negative they can find, they use. Any statement that he makes that can be taken out of context, they do, and they make a soundbite, and then it reverberates throughout the entire world press. They never report anything positive about him. Now, keep in mind that I am a libertarian, and I would never vote for a Democrat nor a Republican if you held a gun to my head. I have very serious policy disagreements with President Trump. However, I try and keep the concept of a fair witness in mind. Plus, of course, the fact that I know that nothing you see in the press is real. Nothing. Well, today I'm bringing you something that I've not fully researched myself. It has been researched by a very old friend of mine and someone that I believe to be highly analytical and not prone to exaggeration. And his research was also later than him, largely confirmed by another news and opinion source. I consequently believe that the entire scandal, as researched by my friend and the second source, I believe it's totally true. They reached the conclusions independently of each other. My friend did it about 24 hours before this other source. So here's what I have learned in the last 24 hours. The Ukraine scandal has nothing to do with President Trump. It is actually an active collusion between the Democratic National Committee, Americans both in and out of government, and Ukrainian nationals, also both in and out of government. And their explicit goal was to influence the 2016 election in order to sway voters away from Trump and toward Hillary Clinton. Now, I can't explain this to you. It involves an extremely complex series of events and actors. I've tried to think of some way to explain it, but I just can't do it. Fortunately, however, someone has done it and released it as a video on YouTube, and that person is Glenn Beck. Now, I know that if you follow Glenn Beck, he largely discredited himself by making the 2016 election into a referendum on God. I myself used to listen to his radio program, but I became very turned off when he did this. No election is a referendum on God. It is nothing more and nothing less than a popularity contest. It is two or more individuals trying to get as many votes as possible in the same way as did your class president in high school. The only marginally different thing from a class president election is that, to some extent, the candidates are banking on the idea that some of their political philosophies will be more popular than the other candidates. They believe that they are either inherently, there will be enough people who agree with them that they can win, or that they can convince enough people to vote for them. It is also sometimes about just plain old charisma. In the 2020 election, Hillary had practically no charisma, where Trump was overflowing with it. And this should be no surprise, given that Trump was a TV star. He knows how to work the crowd, and he knows how to manipulate the press. He was also, and this is something that's going to go in the history books, he was also the first president to successfully leverage social media. Just as Franklin Delano Roosevelt will be remembered as the first president to leverage radio, Trump will be remembered as the first to leverage social media. And you can also see it now with all the political candidates. Most of them are completely failing with social media, but there are standouts like Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez, always, by the way, referred to as Red Cortez on Tales from SYL Ranch because it fits. So when Glenn Beck attempted to make the 2016 a referendum on God, a lot of people turned him off. In fact, most of the successful media empire that he was attempting to build at that time went completely belly up. And he is now considered something of a crank, a conspiracy nut that is derided more often than he's lauded. However, in this case, his staff seems to have gotten it right. I've consequently got a link in my description box for his explanation video, which includes the timestamp where the relevant part begins. It's called Ukraine, the Democrats, Russia. And again, in my description box below, I have a link to that. Now, don't pay much attention to Beck's comparison of the scandal to an episode of Columbo. If you're not my age, you may not even know who Columbo was. But that's just his hook. Pay attention to the blackboards and how he lays things out. I will warn you in advance, this thing is complex. Beck uses two entire blackboards for his explanation, as well as many pictures of the various actors and where and when they come into play. It's long. It may be hard to follow. If you need to, back the thing up in order to keep it straight in your mind. If I ever figure out a way to present this on Tales from SYL Ranch, it will be with the help of that old friend of mine, at the very least, and probably one of his old friends. It'll be the first time, really, that my videos would be heavily edited rather than just me talking with occasional visual aids over my shoulder or, you know, green screen like you see behind me. The Ukraine scandal is massive, wild, and exposes the Democratic Party doing exactly what they accused Trump of doing with Russia. The part that really bothers me is this. I don't see a clear path to justice. I don't know how you get there, given the current political climate, combined with the press on a jihad to destroy Trump. I think it would need a special counsel, the same as the Russian collusion narrative was handled. It might take two or more years for the investigation to be concluded, and for that entire time, Democrats and the press would be working tirelessly to discredit everything and anyone having anything remotely to do with the investigation. Now, a president can order the Justice Department to appoint a special counsel. The problem is, Trump can't do it right now. It is now well into an election year cycle, so he'd be seen as attempting to destroy his political rivals. Now, if Trump isn't reelected, none of this will ever be investigated. The various actors will never be brought to justice. If Trump is reelected, then he'll be facing rampant civil unrest. And as I mentioned in my most recent video, United States Civil War in 2020, I think there's every reason to believe that the regressive left will use violence against anyone with whom they disagree. And there could be something like, or actually a, civil war. And then Trump will be forced to fight this war, quite possibly with deadly force. Now, under those circumstances, he dare not have a special counsel appointed. It would only inflame the situation. Now, if I'm wrong, and I hope very much that I am, the Democrats and aggressive left will continue to be wailing and whining and carrying on the exact same thing that we've seen since the moment that Trump was elected. Now, if the Democrats keep the House, which, frankly, I think highly unlikely, then the special counsel's report will probably be completely dismissed. They will make every effort to discredit it and will probably be successful. If the Republicans take the House and keep the Senate, and if there is no civil war, then Trump can appoint a special counsel and probably will be seen through to conclusion. However, the entire time, he will be attacked by the Democrats and the press. They will use every trick available to discredit it. And that includes intentionally inflaming their base and the regressive left. And that might lead to violence or civil war. The reason for all of this is very simple. If my friend and Glenn Beck are correct, it will utterly destroy the Democratic Party. Some of the higher-ups in the DNC will go to prison. It will mar the entire party for at least a generation, just as President Nixon did to the Republicans. Nixon's actions reverberate to this very day. It's why Democrats have such success making Republicans look bad, even if they don't deserve it. The scandal may well destroy the Democratic Party. It might well be that they become a complete non-entity. If there is a path to justice, an easy one, then it involves an extremely improbable circumstance. Someone other than a Democrat or a Republican must win the presidency. Now, personally, I would hope, of course, that it's a Libertarian, but to be honest, it doesn't matter, as long as it's not a Democrat or a Republican. Only a third-party president could create a special counsel without completely inflaming the left. Republicans would probably go along with it. Democrats, of course, in the press would still try to destroy it, but they would be handicapped by not having a known entity to kick around. However, this is an extremely improbable scenario at best. Consequently, I don't see any path to justice. This is a win scenario. And that is all that I have to say about that. I would love to keep the conversation going, so please leave your comments, questions, and nasty remarks, and I'll do my best to respond to you. So, thanks for watching. That's all the time that we have today for this episode of the highly acclaimed, world-renowned Tales from SYL Ranch, the BitChute channel where everyone is entitled to my opinion. And remember, there's not enough time to stop the world from being destroyed by civil war, by climate change, so remember to eat your babies. And I'm Bill Stone.
Ultimate power in this world has always been one simple thing: the control and manipulation of minds.